Three. Go.
And so the Word of God makes a real plain in the book of Ephesians.
Okay.
He says that we may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, the length, the depth, and the height, and to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, and that you might be filled with the fullness of God.
Yeah.
Now, to be filled with the fullness of God is to be filled with the Spirit, to be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Are you operating in the fruit of the Spirit? Can people see love in you and peace and joy? Are you patient with people? Have you learned that sometimes you have to go through a process, what we call long suffering? What about goodness? Amen.
Yes.
And temperance. Faith, amen, and gentleness. All of these things, being filled with the, amen, the knowledge of God and with the fruit of the Spirit and the fullness of God. God wants his people to be full of grace and full of his mercy, of kindness, and most of all, full of his love, because God is love.
Yes.
And he said, amen. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask, all that we ask, or think,
yes,
according
Lord.
To the power that's working in us. Unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end.
Yes,
and so
Lord,
now unto him who is able. Well, you know, I always think about when I read this scripture that God is able. We used to sing this song, he's able. Amen.
Amen.
And he's able to do
what he said he would do.
What he said he can do. Can't remember the name of the artist that sang that, but I remember God is able.
Yes.
And to do what he said he can do. He'll lift you up.
Yes.
Amen. When trouble comes your way. Amen. Yeah, it's going to come back to me. I'm downloading it now. But nevertheless, when I remember that song.
Hosanna.
God is able.
Yes.
Amen. And it came out back in the, I think the 80s. Late 80s or early 90s. And y'all probably remember, y'all might remember before I do. Let me know. Call me. Let me know. But nevertheless, the songwriter talks about God is able.
Yes.
And he's able to do what he said he could do. Remember, he keeps his promises. And
thank
when
you,
God's
Jesus
people
Christ.
Are full of faith.
Ben Canoli.
Remember when Joshua and Caleb, when the children of Israel were coming out of Egypt, and they were receiving now their inheritance, their portion, and Moses had the spy out the land, he said, and had them to spy out the land, and what did Caleb and Joshua say? We be well able.
We be able.
Why? Because God is able.
Yes,
he'll bring you through this coronavirus season. And it's just for a season. I don't know how long it's going to last.
Yes.
But this too will pass. It's true what the Word of God says. This too will pass. So so God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we can ask or think. And the power that's working us is the power of God's Spirit operating in our life. Okay, Isaiah 41, he says, fear thou not, for I am with thee, and be not dismayed. How many of you know that Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you? And he also gives us a word of admonishment when he said, draw nigh unto me, and I'll draw nigh unto you. If you draw nigh unto God, I guarantee that God will show up. He'll show up in your prayer life.
Yes, Lord.
While you're giving them glory to God and hallelujahs and thank you, Jesus. And Lord, I know you're able.
Yes, Lord.
You can sense every time I say Jesus in my
hallelujah.
Home, every time I call on his name, I can feel his presence.
Yes, Lord.
When I say Jesus, amen, I can feel
thank
the
you,
worry
Jesus.
And the anxiety that tries to latch on. And you don't have to turn that TV off. And I want to suggest to some of y'all, you can't allow that to just stay on day and night. Amen. Because remember, we have an eye gate. And we have an ear gate. Amen.
Yes,
and
Jesus.
So what you see, that gate, it enters into your body. Remember, you're a triune being.
Yes, yes.
But you have your tabernacle, your body. But you possess a soul, which is the seat of your will, your intellect, and your emotion. And you are a spirit. And so whatever you feed on, amen, you become. You are what you eat physically. You are what you eat spiritually. So I try to stay with the Word of God. But Jesus said, give us, as he taught the disciples how to pray, give us this day our daily bread.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Job said, I esteem the word of his mouth more than my necessary food.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
And so you want to feed more on the Word of God than on the media. Amen.
Amen.
You need that because it's going to help keep you strong and keep you lifted. Because remember, God will hold you up. Amen.
Yes, amen.
Amen. He will hold you up. And then he says in Psalms 119, uphold me according to thy word that I may live. and let me not be ashamed of my hope. Mm-hmm. Hope maketh not ashamed.
Yes.
Amen. We know that faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things not seen. So somebody might say, well, it ain't changed not. This has been going on for the last 2 or 3 months. Mm-hmm. Ain't nothing changed. Yes, but you know what? In the midst of the situation, mm-hmm. God is changing you. He's changing you to have faith and to believe and to know that he's able. Mm-hmm. Not only that, God said he changes not. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. So the circumstances will not overwhelm. This is not something that God did not know was coming.
Amen.
Back in December of 2019, the Lord gave me a rhema word. He said, when you do the prayer summit next month, or, well, actually, that was 2 months later, because February the 22nd, we had our prayer summit we have every year. This year, the Lord said, no keynote speaker. Mm-hmm. And I kept praying all in January, Lord, but who am I going to get to speak? And I kept hearing the Lord say, I thought maybe I was missing what God was saying about the keynote speaker. But he said, no keynote speaker. And so we gathered at Agape Love Deliverance Church, 4716 West Lisbon in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. We gathered there for the prayer summit on that Saturday. Church people from different churches were there. We were magnifying God. We were praying. We prayed for our city, our community, our families, for the African-American community, especially the black men. Amen. We prayed for schools and children. We prayed for our different departments, everything that makes our community. Not realizing that one of the first African-American men to die was a friend of the man that led the prayer, or a relative, actually. He was his cousin. Amen. And that first black man that died was the cousin of the man that led the prayer concerning the salvation of African-American men.
My Lord.
Now, let me just say this. We never know exactly all what God means. We know in part. But I believe that the reason why we couldn't have a keynote speaker is because God himself was speaking. He said, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, he said, I will hear from heaven, forgive their sin, and heal their land. That's what he said in 2 Chronicles 7 and 14. And Jesus said in Luke 18 and 1 that men should what? Always pray and not faint. And Paul tells us to pray without ceasing.
Yes.
The old folks used to be saying, keep a little prayer wheel turning. Keep the fire burning and keep the little prayer wheel turning. Amen?
Amen.
And so we're always to be prayerful. And like never before, prayer changes things.
Amen.
I'm going to say it again. Prayer changes things. So how is God going to hold you up? Part of it is with your prayer life.
Yes.
What about praise? God inhabits the praises of his people.
Hallelujah.
So we talk about prayer, confession of the word of God, and praising God. Because as you give him your glory to God and your hallelujah, you'll find yourself lifted.
Hallelujah.
Have you ever woke up and you were kind of down and you don't even know what exactly? You were feeling kind of, like I hear some people say, some kind of way. You're feeling some kind of way, and you just begin to, he's sweet, I know, dark clouds may rise, and stormy winds may blow, but I'll tell the world, wherever I go, that I have found a Savior. And he's sweet, I know. And you notice it lifts you.
Amen.
Because you know what? When you get into praise, there's something. Your spirit responds to that.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. When you praise God, no matter what your song is that you sing. Mm-hmm. 1 Timothy 6 and 20 says, O Timothy, keep that which is committed to thy trust. Avoid profane and vain babblings and opposition of science falsely so-called. In other words, don't get in a lot of yada, yada, yada with people. And this is a time to watch your words and make sure they're seasoned with grace and with salt.
Yes.
Speak the things that become sound doctrine.
Yes.
If you go into a lot of rattling and suppositions about what's going on, and we know that we study to show ourselves approved under God, a workman who need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But make sure that you keep the word, the sound doctrine of the word. Because if you listen to everything that's going on, and there's so much going on concerning this coronavirus, that if you start allowing all that stuff to download, it can cause a spirit of confusion. But keep what God has committed unto you. He said, and he says in 2 Timothy 1 and 12, for the which cause I also suffer these things, nevertheless I am not ashamed, for I know in whom I have believed. Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah. And I'm persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Mm-hmm. Against what day? The things that I believe about God, his, with his stripes, I am healed. Amen. I know people are getting sick all around us. But he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Mm-hmm. I will say the Lord, he's my refuge, my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Yes. Surely he will keep thee from the snare of the fowler, from the noisome pestilence. Yes. He will cover you under his feathers. So there's a promise, mm-hmm. and there's a secret code in Psalms, the 91st chapter.
Yeah,
I confess that word over me and my daughter, the family, the church, the ministry, even our nation. And I know while all this is going on, people are saying, well, is it working? Yes.
Yes.
Because not everybody's getting it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I sympathize and definitely have compassion and feel compassion and empathy for those whose family members have gotten it. Some of mine have gotten it. Amen. My loved one, I have a few loved ones that has been connected with that. But I'm going to tell you this. God is greater.
Amen.
He's greater than coronavirus. And we need to understand that. Mm-hmm. So, amen. Paul tells Timothy that I'm persuaded that he is able to keep that which I commit unto him against that day. Mm-hmm. Are you persuaded that God is able to keep you from the virus? Mm-hmm. Are you persuaded that God is able to keep you, amen, from dying by the virus, even if you contract it? Mm-hmm. Because some people have contracted, they don't even know how they got, how they were exposed, mm-hmm. or when they were exposed.
Right.
They start showing symptoms. But guess what? While you showing your symptoms, while you giving God praise, glorify God, magnify him,
yes.
and adore him anyway.
Amen.
In Hebrews 1:1-14, he says, God, who at sundry times and in divers manners spake in times past unto the fathers by the prophets. God spoke, amen, yes. to us through the prophets.
Amen.
Remember, the Lord will do nothing unless he reveals it to his servant, the prophets.
Yes.
Amen. But in these last days, he's spoken unto us by his son, whom he have appointed heir of all things, mm-hmm. by whom he also made the world. Mm-hmm. God is still speaking.
Yes.
Jesus is still speaking. Mm-hmm. It's in him we live and move and have our being.
Yes.
He has the ability to hold you up. He is the lifter upper of your head.
Yes.
Rejoice in knowing that God cares for you.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Jesus, amen, was being the who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person,
yes.
and upholding all things by the word of his power.
Yes.
And guess what? He's able to keep you from falling. He's upholding you,
yes.
by his word. Amen. He's the lifter upper,
yes.
David said of my head. When he had himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. He's being made so much better than the angels, mm-hmm. as he had by inheritance obtain a more excellent name than they. That's in the book of Hebrews.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Are they not all ministering spirits, finally,
thank you,
in that
Lord.
First chapter? Are they not all ministering spirit? The 14th verse said, send forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation.
Mm-hmm.
So you're an heir of salvation. So let me leave you with this word. Amen. I want you to be encouraged to know who you are.
All right.
And whose you are. Amen.
Amen.
To know who you are and whose you are. He said how important it is for us to seek the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
He said that they should seek the Lord if happily they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from every one of us. So right now, I want to encourage you. You may not feel like God is with you.
Mm-hmm.
He promises, I'll never leave you.
Yes.
I'll never forsake you. Many of you as parents, you know how much your children sometimes depend upon you,
yes,
and Lord. Need you.
Mm-hmm.
They can't be always with you because they have, sometimes they're working or they're at school or mm-hmm. doing something that has to be done
mm-hmm.
to maintain the life and the health mm-hmm. and the integrity of the family. Well, God maintains
yes.
our life. It's
yes.
in him
yes.
we live and move and have our being.
Yes,
God maintains the integrity of his word.
Yes,
he's
Lord.
Able to keep that which we commit unto him against that day.
Yes,
God
Lord.
Watches over his word to perform it.
Yes,
he settled Lord. It. It's forever settled in heaven.
Yes,
but he sent it to you. And you are heirs and joint heirs with Jesus Christ.
Yes,
so I just want to encourage you today to realize and recognize that God is holding you up.
Yes,
through
Lord.
This season, through this time of the coronavirus,
mm.
chill.
Yes,
just give
Lord.
God the glory and
hallelujah.
Honor and praise. Lift his name up.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. His name Jesus. Is worthy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on and bless God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He's worthy
Hallelujah.
To be praised.
Hallelujah.
His name is greater.
Oh, Rabbi
Amen.
Shantanas.
His name is greater
yes.
and higher
yes.
than any virus, than any plague, than any disease. Amen. It's hallelujah.
Yes.
Anyhow, all folks just say, when trouble come your way, lift your head up high and say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anyhow.
Yes.
Know that God is holding you up.
Yes.
Well, until we meet again, you have a God-blessed day. A God bless evening, and remember to keep safe, but more than anything, remember to stay strong. And guess what? The joy of the Lord is your strength. He's holding you up. Be blessed.